Welcome, welcome, welcome. We are back
for another installment in the World Tour in the A320 series. I'm trying to get my life together here. We're on leg 79. And
we're flying from Stockholm, Bromma to... It's K-J-E-L-L-E-R. I just call it Kajeller, but it's probably just Jeller. Airport Echo November Kilo Juliet. Where is that? Hold on, I set up that whole thing just for it to not show up. ESB. Today's flight's gonna be rather short. Because I didn't want to do two legs. The next leg is gonna be leg 80 is gonna be like 1100 miles, 1200 miles, something crazy. So I said, let me just separate these two, and then it should be all right. Are we still having technical difficulties with this thing? It looks like we are. Nope, not that. There we go. Alright. So, we already know what we're doing. Today's flight, which is leg 79, we will climb and cruise to flight level 320. Traveling about 218 nautical miles, carrying 10,661 pounds of fuel. Weather at Stockholm Bromma is, let's see here. Alright, so it's low IFR. Ceiling is at 200 feet. Visibility 6 miles. Winds 350 at 4. And temperature is 0. Dew point is 0. So that's probably why it's pretty crappy. Okay. Low IFR. Looks pretty decent to me, right? It's crazy. Let's see. Do we have ATIS? Let's see how that translates into the sim. We do.
Bromma Airport information, Yankee 1000 Zulu. Wind tree 4 tree at 4. Visibility 6. Sky condition, few clouds at 1,800 feet, 13,000 feet scattered. Temperature 0.
So that layer at 200 is not even being depicted.
Altimeter tree. 0.06. ILS runway tree 0 in use.
Gotcha. Alright, so they're using 30. Let's see here. 1046 Zulu. So let's see. 1051 Zulu. 4 minutes, right? That sounds about right. Real time, 2 minutes to load. Let's download the flight plan to the MCDU. Meanwhile, in chat, get the flight plan up. There we go. So we already know we're going to 32,000. Where did the 8 come from? Okay. Alright. AIB 079. Turn the APU on. And the autopilot. 32,000. There, we got that set. Alright, so from here we're taking off runway 30. RS4 Zulu departure. And we're landing on runway 30 as well. Direct. Cool beans. Back to the tablet. Boarding is complete. So we're technically ready to go, but let's see if we have charts. So we can kind of brief. Okay, so airport info, departure. Okay, this departure, and I think that should be it. Cool beans. All right, take a quick look at the airport. All right, so we're on the stand over here. Runway 30 is to our right, so we're gonna push tail to the left to get out of here, and then just taxi along. What's this about, Yankee? Yankee 5. And that should be good. Airport elevation is 47. Alright. Runway 5,472 feet. Good deal. For the departure. Alright, so it's fly runway heading basically to Sierra Bravo 850. Max 230 knots. Then a left turn to Sierra Bravo 854, and continue on to Ars VOR. Simple enough. Simple enough. Okay, so we got that all set up. We just need the weights. 97.2/27, carrying 10.6 on the fuel. Alright, now let's jump over and grab some departure numbers. Alright, taking off on way 30. Let's do a flaps 2, packs on, calculate. /UP 0.568. Alright, I reckon we're good to go. Let's go ahead and ask for that pushback. Is GSX not working? Oh, there we go. Alright. Ice warning, do you request? No.
Due to icing conditions, please stand by for engine start until push completed and brake set.
Alright.
Hello, Captain. We are ready for pushback.
I am too. Windows and doors locked. APU is on. APU bleed is on. Disconnect external power. Fuel pumps on. Let's jump over here, move the chocks and cones as well as the GPU.
Departure check completed. Bypass pin inserted.
Alright, thrust levers are idle, seatbelt signs are on, barrel reference 3006, NES check, fuel quantity 10.6 check, takeoff data, I just set it and reviewed, transponder to auto. Beacon lights are on. And engine mode selector, we're gonna wait for that.
Engine Locking gear.
Tail to the left.
Release parking brakes.
Brakes release.
Commencing push. Due to icing conditions, please stand by for engine start until push completed and brake set.
Alright, this shouldn't be too bad. I thought it was gonna be a longer taxi, but it really doesn't look too bad. So let me flip a couple screens here. Alright.
Set parking brakes.
Brakes set.
Cockpit to ground. We have a good engine start. You can disconnect.
Did not even start the engine. Engine mode selector to ignition start. Master switch 2 on. Alright, number 2 is coming up.
Unlocking gear. Disconnected. Bypass pin removed. Left is clear. Right is clear.
But is it really? Yeah, it looks clear. Alright, that's a good start on 2. Master switch 1 on. Thank you. Come again. Have a good trip. All right, that's a good start on 1. Engine mode selector. Normal. APU bleed off. APU master off. Auto brakes max. Flight controls. Full left. Neutral. Right. Neutral. Up. Neutral. Pull down. Neutral. Left rudder. Neutral. Right rudder. Whoa. See that right rudder? Hold on. Left rudder, right rudder, there we go. Well, there's still like a little area there where it's a little jumpy. It's crazy. Okay. Let's trim up 5. Okay, there we go. Spoilers. On pitch trim, did that rudder trim is reset and zeroed out. Anti-ice, I'm gonna turn all this stuff on just in case. And you know, I didn't think anything of it. Without takeoff numbers, I turn icing off. Anti-ice on engine and wing. Let's see what that does. What do you mean some of my entries were? Okay, still looks the same. Alright. Alright, brakes release. Alright, we're rolling taxi light on. Flaps 2. That up and let's get these people ready to go. It's close to the building. I'm very close to the building. Do I have scenery at this airport? There's a lot of cars. Where are we at? Stockholm. Crazy. Flying the plane yesterday was heavy as a pig, now today is so light. Alright, takeoff config button. And we'll do the before takeoff checklist here. Tapping the brakes there. Okay, cabin crew is advised. Okay. Brake temp should be good even though I was tapping the hell out of it. Brake fans are off. Engine mode selector normal. Packs are on. Weather radar off. Predicted wind shear. Auto. TCAS. TARA. Exterior lights on. Should be good. Alright, power to 50%. Stabilize. Takeoff. Man flex SRS runway. Flaps 1. autopilot on, let's turn off icing. Taxi light off. Disarm. Spoilers. Flaps up. Flight plan real quick. We're doing direct, that's right. So let's clear this discount. Alright, so as we leave Stockholm, Climbing. A lot better than yesterday. Let's turn off exterior lights. Let's check out this departure here. Transition altitude is 5,000. There we go. And we're just heading towards Ars VOR. Seem to have a quarter and tail one as well, so alright, it ain't gonna be as bad as yesterday with the head one either. Alright, so while we're climbing, let's start to take a look at Kjeller Airport. Oh, say it ain't so, there's no charts for it. Alright. Let me do some behind the scenes homework. Alright, it has a 4,452 foot runway. It is asphalt, and it is in, how do you pronounce this? It doesn't tell you how to pronounce it? That's crazy. It is in Norway though. It's a military and general aviation airport located in Kjeller in Skedsmo in Viken County, Norway. Situated in the outskirts of Lillestrøm, 9 miles from northeast Oslo. Interesting. So we know we have a runway 30 and 14 as well as about 4,400 feet of runway that is asphalt. Let's see if I can find any more information. Of course not. It would make too much sense to have weather.
Alright, elevation's 354 feet. This is hours of operation 9 to 2300 all week. And then it also says airport closed all week. That is hilarious. Hold on. Okay, it looks like it is a terminal area. At least a pretty decent size ramp. Excuse me. Alright, coming through 23,032. Kind of a long final game. Let's see. More than 160 miles, another 172. Never did get wet and I was thinking about it. Alright, so it's saying that it's VFR, it's -4, winds are 0503. Clear. 1019 on the QA. Okay.
Alright, so we're at 320. What is it saying? 21 minutes? That's what it claims. 21 minutes to go. Speaking of which, just messed that up. All right. PSI. Are you serious? How did I get this password wrong? What? Oh, I know what it is. Duh. Can't have same number twice. TOD is coming up. Less than 20 miles. We don't know exactly, so we're gonna do it like last time. There's no charts, so we're gonna play it like an instrument approach, even though it's VFR. So we might be able to score down to 3,000 feet. Yeah, let's play it that way. If it was IFR, I would have took it down to 200, but 3,000 should be safe. Alright, start our descent. plane looking extra fresh. Okay. Says terrain standby. But if I remember correctly, winds were 050 at 3:10:19 on the QNH. Temperature was 0. That's crazy. I've never seen that terrain standby before. I didn't think about it like what is. Terrain and ND is here. Oh, it's not coming on either. Maybe it has something to do with that. Fix it. Nope. Very strange to me.
But I swear everything is on. I didn't skip anything. Yeah, that is weird that it's giving me this. Coming through 10,000 now, so we're slowing. It says terrain standby is displayed on ECAM when current GPS position is not accurate enough to support terrain warnings on ND. Happens quite often. Radar unit, turn the switch mode to map. Okay. Nope, still. On map. No, terrain standby still there. That is actually very different. Yeah, I don't know. I've tried everything. And nothing is working. All right, we're about 22 miles, maybe 23. Such a great guess. Trying to make sure I didn't skip anything else. But no, I don't see any reason for me to be having that warning. Grass is green on the other side. Welcome to Norway. How far out are we? That's 15 miles with extra. So maybe about 16, 17 miles. We're at 5,600 now. Slowing down the green dot. quick turn the final here. Just about 10 miles, maybe 11 miles out, 10 and a half. Oh, I see the airport. I see it. Flaps 1. If what I'm looking at is it, I see it right there. Alright, let's set this bad boy up. Alright, flaps 2. Gear down. Spoilers on. Alright, flaps 4. Alright, it's on us now. Alright, before landing checklist, cabin crew advise landing gear down, flaps set landing. Spoilers armed, auto brakes not using them, engine mode selector normal, engine mode selector. I said it already. Exterior lights checked, go on altitude, there ain't no charts, so I don't know what to tell you. ECAM memo, no blue. Alright, so far that looks good. Alright, there's transition altitude.
1,000.
Very beautiful landscape here. Why would it do that? To the left, I mean to the right, from what I remember seeing on
500
online. Is that a road?
Right. 200.
Oh, it's a open field.
100. 50. 40. 30. 20. Retard. 5.
Bounce. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Norway. Is there only one parking spot here? Stop playing with me. Crazy. All right, we could do it like this. I can do it just like this. park right there. Brake set. Master's off. Fuel pump on. You know, I didn't even clean this plane up. Alright, hit these lights. External power, give me that. Deboard. Ground services. That was actually kind of crazy. We got a panel still up because I did not clean myself up before I shut the engines off. Fun times. Alright. So that's leg 79 in the books. Like I said, it's a pretty short leg. And I knew it coming into it. Next leg is from here, which is Kajeller Airport, to Svalbard Airport, Longyear, ENSB. So, just to give you an idea, yeah, it's about 1,100 nautical miles before I even put a flight plan in, so that'll be on Wednesday, and that's damn near 3 hours long, so this runway is awfully short for fully loaded. I mean, we only got fuel, so it should be fine, but thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys on the next turn. Peace.